Hi everyone, welcome. Yvette here. I hope everybody's doing well. I want to share this beautiful altered canvas that I made for the swap that I host over at Your Paper Pantry. My swap is called The Junk Market, and for the month of March, I went ahead and I made this altered canvas. The theme was retro women's fashion, and I picked the 1920s. So these are flapper girls that I have here, and I found the image on the internet, so I kind of borrowed that, and I took the canvas and I've altered it. I have a couple of pictures of the process for you at the end, and also more pictures of the canvas. But meanwhile, let me show you what I've done. I've taken the picture and I've distressed it just a little bit, and then where naturally the ladies have these beautiful pearl necklaces, I've taken enamel accents, and that's what that looks like right here. And I took it in white and in black, and I've went ahead, and as you can see here, I did it for the necklace and the earrings, and here as well, and there's the black, and it has dimension to it. So I'm not sure if you can see that, but it's super cool. Lots and lots of dimension. Oops. And so I've done that, and I did it again here for the ring, but it wasn't dimensional enough for me, so I took some of this Prima Satin Pearls, as you can see here. I took that there, and I stole a little piece from there, and I put it in a ring here. And then again, I used the enamel accents here in the other hand, which has turned out really cool. And then I found this beautiful piece over at Michael's, and that is from the Bead Gallery. So they come in these packages. It's a little brown package if you guys want to get that for your own projects. Then here we move over, and I have this ornate plate from Tim Holtz, and this I just printed from my, you know, I just did it in Word and printed 1920s on there. Then I have this beautiful, beautiful piece right here, and that too is from the Bead Gallery, and that's just this part and this part here. I've added little jump rings to the ornate plate so that it has movement. And then, you know, because flapper girls wore those beautiful dresses with the fringe, and that's what I wanted to portray here. So most of my artwork always has some kind of a story behind it. And so these beads right here are from Lost and Found, and that's these guys. And I don't know if these are still being made. I've had them for a while. I've been putting them away in my stash, so it was kind of hard to give them up. Anyway, and then moving on the background here, I gessoed my entire canvas, and then I used Lumiere paint, and this is in pearl turquoise. It's 571 pearl turquoise. It's beautiful color, you guys. And then as you can see back here, it has texture. So all throughout the canvas I added some texture, and what I did is I took this woven, like natural woven material, and I pressed it up against the canvas while it was still semi-wet. I let it set for a few minutes, and then when it was not quite dry, I went ahead and I pressed down and then lifted up and got this beautiful texture in the back. I don't know if you can see that. There it is. And then I've taken a zipper, and this is a 7-inch zipper, and you know, I got it at Joanne, looks like that, just a zipper. And I've used, of course, my Lindy Stamp Gang, and of course my favorite color, which is Desert Moon Blazing Sun, and I spritz it, and it gave it this beautiful sheen. But you guys, not only did it give it a beautiful sheen, here's a technique, okay, pay attention, technique girls. You can take this and add it to fabric, and I've added it to a couple of different types of fabric, and of course this is polyester, and I've added it to that, and it's stiffened it. I'm not sure what the properties are. I'm not sure if it's even supposed to do that or not, but hey, it's a cool technique and another use for your glitz spritz or your Lindy Stamp Gang's, you know, Starburst sprays, and yeah, they're just wonderful over there. So and we are having a blog hub coming up, so pay attention to that, girls. That's coming up. Anyway, so yeah, it stiffened it. It made it super stiff, which is really cool. It gave it a texture that I really wanted in this project. Here I have another little ephemera, and it says 1920s scrapbook. And then here I took a little spool of ribbon. I mean spool of thread and put it here, and of course added my signature needle right there. And then here I've used my I Am Roses, beautiful I Am Roses, and I sprayed them with my glitz spritz. So it gives it this beautiful shimmer and it gives it like an antique-y look, which is really cool. And then here is my signature pin. Most of my projects have a pin that I specifically make for each individual project. And then down here, this is a beautiful trim, and I got this trim from Beverly over at the Piece by Piece, so you guys need to check her out. It's super cool. Anyway, so that is my project, and like I said, oh, and here's more I Am Roses. And this one I added Bayou Boogie Gold and Desert Moon Blazing Sun to do that little flowers in there. So two little flowers for that. So Lindy Stamp Gang and then I Am Roses right there. Super, super cool project to make. It turned out super cool. I also, all of the edges, I went ahead and all of my edges, I've distressed just a little bit with some ColorBox chalk fluid ink and or fluid chalk ink in Chestnut Roan all across the top and the sides. Yeah, and that's my project. If you have any questions and if you want to check out more pictures of my projects, stick around. Also, I wanted to let you guys know that I have lots of things going on over at my blog, so if you haven't checked me out, it's vetcarillo.blogspot.com. Come over and take a look at what I'm up to. Take care, you guys. Bye.